क्रिस्टल्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। इन प्रीवियस पार्ट ऑन ब्रेस्ट कैंसर वी हैड लर्नड अबाउट इंट्रोडक्शन, कोजेस, स्टेजेस एंड टाइप्स ऑफ ब्रेस्ट कैंसर। हियर इन दिस फर्स्ट सेकंड पार्ट वी विल लर्न अबाउट डायग्नोसिस एंड मैनेजमेंट इन डिटेल। सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग सो मच टाइम, लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। डायग्नोसिस ऑफ द ब्रेस्ट कैंसर। The test and procedure used to diagnose breast cancer include breast exam. Your doctor will check both of your breast and lymph nodes in your armpit, feeling for any lumps or other abnormalities. We will also do a self-examination of breast and address some abnormalities which are not present before. So we can prevent the breast cancer by early treatment. I put a link for self-examination, so you can also do self-examination at home. The next is a mammogram. A mammogram is an X-ray of the breast. Mammograms are commonly used to screen for breast cancer. If an abnormality is detected on a screening mammogram, your doctor may recommend a diagnostic mammogram to further evaluate that abnormality. This is the picture for the breast self-examination. You can see the any changes on your breast and prevent the further breast cancer or other abnormalities present in your breast. This is a picture of mammogram. In mammography, each breast is compressed horizontally. During the screening mammogram, the breast is placed between two plastic plates. These plates then are briefly compressed to flatten the breast tissue. Two views are usually taken from each breast, which are craniocaudal and mediolateral. You can see the mammogram pictures. The cancer is seen on mammogram like this. The benign cyst, the calcium deposition, and this is the picture of normal breast tissue. This is how the mammography done. The third is breast ultrasound. We can also use the ultrasound which produces the sound waves to produce images of structure of deep tissue within the body. Ultrasound may be used to determine whether a new breast lump is solid mass or a fluid filled cyst. This is the image for the ductal invasive carcinoma. We can see this on ultrasound. And this is the chart for breast density classification. This is the normal breast, and this is scattered areas heterogeneously, and this is extremely dense, which indicates some tumor or other abnormalities. We can also do a biopsy to check the further abnormalities. During the biopsy, your doctor uses a specialized needle device guided by X-ray or another imaging test to extract a core of tissue from the suspicious area. Often, a small metal marker is left at the site within your breast, so the area can be easily identified on a future imaging test. Biopsy samples are sent to a laboratory for analysis, where experts determine whether the cells are cancerous or not. A biopsy sample is also analyzed to determine the type of cells involved in the breast cancer, the aggressiveness of the cancer, and whether the cancer cells have hormone receptors or other receptor. In this criteria, we can identify a triple negative cancer that may influence your treatment options. The MRI. An MRI machine uses a magnet and a radio waves to create picture of the interior of your breast. Before a breast MRI, you can receive an injection of dye. Look, this is the picture of the normal breast, and this is the abnormal area in the MRI. Now on the treatment. So the treatment of a breast cancer is based on your type of breast cancer, its stage and the grade, size and whether the cancer cells are sensitive to hormones or not. Your doctors also considers your overall health and your own preferences. So the first is breast cancer surgery. In the breast cancer surgeries, many treatments are included like lumpectomy, mastectomy, and in other treatment options there is a chemotherapy, radiotherapy, palliative treatment are also included. So let's start with the breast cancer surgery. So the operations used to treat the breast cancer include removing the breast cancer, which is called a lumpectomy. During a lumpectomy, which may be referred to as a breast conserving surgery or a wide local excision, the surgeon removes the tumor and a small margin of surrounding healthy tissue. A lumpectomy may be recommended for removing the small tumors like the benign cyst, some benign tumor, ductal carcinoma in situ, etc. Some people with larger tumors may undergo chemotherapy before surgery to shrink a tumor and make it possible to remove completely with a lumpectomy procedure. See, this is the procedure for the lumpectomy. This is the area of the tumor and after the lumpectomy surgery. This is the incision. This is the procedure for lumpectomy. First we had under anesthesia and the incision is made and the lymph nodes are removed, cancerous lymph nodes or benign cyst. The next is removing the entire breast, which is called the mastectomy. A mastectomy is an operation to remove all of your breast tissue. Most mastectomy procedures remove all of the breast tissues, which are the lobules, ducts, fatty tissue and some skin, including the nipple and areola. Total, which is called a total or simple mastectomy. In the newer surgical techniques, may be an option in selected cases in order to improve the appearance of the breast. So the skin sparing mastectomy and the nipple sparing mastectomy are increasingly common operations for the breast cancer. See, this is the procedure for procedure of mastectomy, where the right side of breast is removed. All tissues of the breast are removed. The next is removing a limited number of lymph nodes, which is called the sentinel node biopsy. To determine whether cancer has spread to your lymph nodes, your surgeon will discuss with you the role of removing the lymph nodes that are the first to receive the lymph drainage from your tumor. If no cancer is found in those lymph nodes, the chance of finding cancer in any of the remaining lymph nodes is too small and no other nodes need to be removed. This is the sentinel lymph node biopsy. So we can identify whether the cancer is present in the breast or not. Next is removing several lymph nodes, which is called axillary lymph node dissection. If the cancer is found in the sentinel lymph node biopsy, your surgeon will discuss with you and the role of removing additional lymph nodes from your armpit. Can you see this? These are green lymph nodes which are present in your armpit. This is the axillary dissection. First, we can take a biopsy the breast tissue. Then the cancer is suspected. Then we incision is made on armpit, and all lymph nodes, axillary lymph nodes, are removed from your armpit. द नेक्स्ट इज रिमूविंग द बोथ ब्रेस्ट. सम वुमन विथ कैंसर इन वन ब्रेस्ट मे चूज टू हैव देयर अदर हेल्दी ब्रेस्ट रिमूव्ड कॉन्ट्रालेटरल प्रोफाइलेक्टिक मास्टेक्टॉमी इफ दे हैव अ वेरी इंक्रीज रिस्क ऑफ कैंसर इन द अदर ब्रेस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ अ जीनेटिक प्रीडिस्पोजिशन और अ स्ट्रॉन्ग फैमिली हिस्ट्री. मोस्ट वुमन विथ ब्रेस्ट कैंसर इन वन ब्रेस्ट विल नेवर डेवलप कैंसर इन द अदर ब्रेस्ट. You may choose to have a breast reconstruction after surgery. Discuss your options and preferences with your surgeon. Consider a referral to a plastic surgeon before your breast cancer surgery. Your options may include reconstruction with a breast implant, silicone or water, or reconstruction using your own tissue. These operations can be performed at the time of your mastectomy or at a later date. The next is radiation therapy. The radiation therapy uses high-powered beams of energy such as X-rays and protons to kill the cancer cells. First, I will show you an image. This is an external beam radiation. This is a brachytherapy, which is called the internal radiation therapy, in which radiation delivered through the catheters in the breast. And this is a proton beam therapy. The radiation therapy is typically done using a large machine that aims the energy beams at your body, which is called the external beam radiation. But radiation can also be done by placing radioactive material inside your body, which is called the brachytherapy. External beam radiation of the whole breast is commonly used after a lumpectomy. Breast brachytherapy may be an operation after a lumpectomy if you have a low risk of cancer recurrence. Doctors may also recommend radiation therapy to the chest wall after a mastectomy for a larger breast cancers or cancers that have spread to the lymph nodes. Breast cancer radiation can last from 3 to 6 weeks. Depending on the treatment. Side effects of radiation therapy include fatigue or red, sunburn-like rash where the radiation is aimed. Breast tissue may also appear swollen or more firm. Rarely, more serious problems may occur such as damage to the heart or lungs, or very rarely, second cancers in the treated area. The third is chemotherapy. Chemotherapy uses drugs to destroy fast-growing cells such as the cancer cells. If your cancer has a high risk of returning or spreading to another part of your body, your doctor may recommend chemotherapy after surgery to decrease the chance that the cancer will recur. Chemotherapy is sometimes given before surgery in women with a larger breast tumors. The goal is to shrink a tumor to a size that makes it easier to remove with a surgery. Chemotherapy is also used in women whose cancer has already spread to other parts of her body. Chemotherapy may be recommended to try to control the cancer and decrease any symptoms of the cancer. Chemotherapy side effects depend on the drugs you receive. Common side effects include hair loss, nausea, vomiting, fatigue, and increased risk of developing infection. Rare side effects can include premature menopause, infertility if the woman is premenopausal, damage to the heart and the kidneys, nerve damage, and very rarely blood cell cancers. The next is hormone therapy. We discuss the estrogen and the progesterone hormone in our last breast cancer lecture. So the hormone therapy is based on blocking the estrogen to join with the receptors which are present on cancer cells. So we can reduce the growth of the cancer cells. Hormone therapy, perhaps more properly termed as a hormone blocking therapy. It is used to treat the breast cancer that are sensitive to hormones. Doctors refer to this cancer as a estrogen receptor positive and progesterone receptor positive cancers. Hormone therapy can be used before or after the surgery or the other treatments to decrease the chance of your cancer returning. If the cancer has already spread, hormone therapy may shrink and control of it. Treatments that can be used in hormone therapy include which are medications that block the hormones from attaching to the cancer cells, which is called the selective estrogen receptor modulators, and the medications that stop the body from making the estrogen after the menopause, and the surgery or medications to stop hormone production in the ovaries. In short, we have to decrease the level of estrogen or blocking the estrogen to attach to the receptors which are present on cancer cells, so we can reduce the growth of the cancer cells. See, in this picture you can easily understand what I am telling. Look, estrogen and progesterone molecule, which is attached with the estrogen molecules, which increase the growth of the cancer cells. When we block this estrogen to bind with the receptor, we can prevent the growth of the tumor. Hormone therapy side effects depend on your specific treatment, but may include hot flashes, night sweats, and the vaginal dryness. More serious side effects include a risk of bone thinning and a blood clots. The next is targeted therapy drugs. Targeted drug treatments attack specific abnormalities within the cancer cells. As an example, several targeted therapy drugs focus on a protein that some breast cancer cells overproduce, which is called the HER2, human epidermal growth factor receptor 2. The protein helps the breast cancer cells to grow and survive. By targeting cells that make too much HER2, the drugs can damage cancer cells while sparing healthy cells. Targeted therapy drugs that focus on other abnormalities within the cancer cells are available, and targeted therapy is an active area of cancer research. Your cancer cells may be tested to see whether you might benefit from targeted therapy drugs. Some medications are used after surgery to reduce the risk that the cancer will return. Others are used in cases of advanced breast cancer to slow the growth of the tumor. The next is immunotherapy. As the name suggests, we can increase our immune system to attack the cancer cell. Immunotherapy uses your immune system to fight the cancer cells. Your body's disease fighting immune system may not attack your cancer cells because the cancer cells produce protein that bind to the immune system cells. So the immunotherapy works by interfering with that process. Immunotherapy might be an option if you have triple negative breast cancer, which means that the cancer cells don't have receptors for estrogen, progesterone, or HER2. For triple negative breast cancer, immunotherapy is combined with the chemotherapy to treat advanced cancers that spread to the other parts of the body. And the last is palliative treatment. The palliative care is a specialized medical care that focuses on providing relief from pain and other symptoms of a serious illness. Palliative care can be used while undergoing other aggressive treatments such as surgery, chemotherapy, or radiation therapy. When palliative care is used along with all of the other appropriate treatments, people with cancer may feel better and live longer. Palliative care is provided by a team of doctors, nurses, and other specially trained professionals. Palliative care team aim to improve the quality of life for people with cancer and their families. This form of care is offered alongside curative or other treatments you may be receiving. Thank you. Here, our video on breast cancer is completed. I hope you like this video and take so much worthful information from this. So don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Bye, friends.